Hello, hello, hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of Problem Solver Garage. In today's episode, we are putting a Palini Sport 70cc, here's the code for it, big bore kit on a E-ton Beamer matrix with a Minarelli Horizontal engine. Lots of scooters have these engines. We got the kit from scootertuning.ca. Awesome, awesome, awesome place with tons and tons of parts. Check it out. So before we get started, just full out disclosure. The scooter is an E-ton Beamer matrix, but it is completely modified and changed around to make it look like another brand, which it actually isn't. So full disclosure there. I mean, girls think it's a Beamer. So I mean, it's a nice looking scooter. All right, so in today's video, we are putting a 70cc kit on. I'm gonna get very, very specific on how to prep this properly. Lots of people get it wrong. And this scooter currently has a 70cc kit in it, but it's a cheap, cheap, cheap eBay one, not a brand name one. So we're gonna take that one out. The scooter still runs. And we're just gonna see after 2 years of having a cheap one in there, what it looks like. And we're gonna compare the quality to this Palini one here, side by side. And also when that 70cc kit was put on there 2 years ago, it wasn't prepped properly. It was literally just put on straight out of the box. So I'll show you what can happen if you do that wrong. Anyways, let's get started. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is just take some of these plastics off and get to the motor. This is super, super easy, guys. Anybody can do it. All right, we're not gonna get too into the plastic removal part, but you take off your seat, couple screws here and there, couple screws here, wherever, and you just take it all apart. So we're gonna do that right now. All right, we got it, all the plastics off basically, super good access, like we're trying to get in here. So we're gonna take the air box off now. You got basically two like Allen key kind of screws in this thing. Yeah, you squish it and this just comes right out. Let's do that. Okay guys, I just took the air box off and you guys have to pay attention to this. So once you take it off, you gotta look inside and see, this one is perfect. There's not one little speck of rocks or anything. It's the way it's supposed to be. See, a lot of times guys make the mistake of putting these type of filters on, and I mean, these things are blowing people's engines up like you wouldn't believe. If I had this on there and I would have taken it off, right inside of there, there would be little rocks and dust and everything going into the motor. See, the reason this motor ran even on a super, super crappy big bore kit with no issues is because it's getting super clean air through the air box. The air box is your most important thing on your motor as far as I'm concerned. If you get, you know, some kind of big bore kit and you can't use your air box, you're gonna have to build an air box or at least get a good brand name filter, like with a big sponge on it, not one of these little cheap ones. When you put like this into the light, you can see right through it. I've literally blown an engine because of this before on a different scooter. So just letting you guys know, rule number one, if you want your engine to last, you need a good clean air supply go into your motor. All right, let's continue. All right guys, so what we're gonna do next is underneath here, there's two screws. We're gonna take the exhaust off. There's no way around it. Just take it off, it makes it easier. So let's pull it off. Okay, the exhaust is off. We're only about half an hour maybe into all of this with the plastics included, so this is very quick. Now we're gonna take this cover off. There's just a couple Phillips head screws going around, no big deal. Okay guys, so we got that off. What we gotta do now is we gotta unscrew. I just went to the other side. Unscrew this thing. We're just gonna move it out of the way, that way we don't have to drain the fluid and we can still keep it connected. This is the tank for the oil. So we're gonna move that next. There's like two screws holding it. Okay guys, so once you got this out of the way, so this cover here, it almost kind of just pulls off, but right here on this side, see, you just have to pry it out. It's got like clips, see right there. So you just gotta get those out. See, there you go. And then that will just come off. you just got to kind of turn it counterclockwise, and there we go. All right, we got that accessed pretty good. So next, we got those four bolts there, and that head should just come right off. So you loosen each one a little bit. You don't just take one off all the way. You kind of go like that. It's the same thing when you're putting it back on. Little bit at a time until they're loose. See all these like little metal, almost kind of shavings? I'll show you what those are from once we get this all apart and on the table. All right, guys, well, this was clearly on its last few drives before this engine would have blown. Look how scored up that is. I'll show you better once we take it out. So now you get some needle nose pliers. There's a little pin inside of there, and you just take that out and you slide that pin out. I guess we're gonna take both pins out. Seems to be stuck. All right. There we go. And this part here, this bearing, if it's in good shape, it just gets reused. So keep track of the direction. So like you wouldn't put it in this way. Keep track of the way it was, put it in the exact same way. All right, guys, so that's what that looks like. This looks good. This is gonna, we can just reuse this the way it is. Nothing looks damaged in there. If you move it like this way and this way, there shouldn't be any play, which there isn't, but side to side, there's always a little bit, and that's about fine. So everything's good there. So this is ready to be just put back together. All right, let's move on. Okay, guys, I got them side by side. And I mean, the quality of this Palini one is honestly 100 times better than this no-name brand one. Okay, so let's take a look at the piston really quick. I mean, look how scored up this thing is. It still ran good, but it was at its last couple drives, honestly, time to rebuild. Okay, so you might wonder like why that happens. Well, I'll show you what you got to do to the new one so that doesn't happen, and also I'll show you another reason why it happens. Okay, so the channels here where it gets air, see these channels in this new one are very, very clean inside. See what I mean? They're finished very, very well, all of them. You basically don't have to do anything to those. Those are ready on the inside there. And then this other one, this cheap one here, I mean, look, when I scrape in here, even after running for 2 years, particles are still flying out right onto the paper. See, look at all those. See, somebody just literally took this thing, put it on without even prepping it, without doing anything to it, just took it right out of the box and put it on. You got to clean those channels super, super good on these, especially these cheap ones. So that's the first thing. And the second thing you got to do on this, that is very, very important, even on the Palini one, that you have to do, is all these edges in here. See right there, like this edge, all around, all of these ones, they're all like razor sharp. They really honestly are. They're razor, razor sharp. So when you got the piston going up and down super, super fast, the rings, they will actually kind of catch on those sharp corners. See, like right there, this sharp edge. So like on this cheaper one, I mean, this already happened on it. Here, let me zoom right in on it so you can see really, really good. See, so what ends up happening is little, like, the rings will catch it and like little particles just like, it's hard to see here, but anyways, they just break off. See, like a piece will break off and then it just scores it up wherever a piece breaks off. And I mean, look, this thing even cracked here. It's definitely time for a change. But see, you can see where the little lip or edge broke off, and then a piece of metal got stuck in there and squirted up. See what I mean? Like, look at this one. So what you got to do is get yourself a Dremel like this or some little files, and you have to get in to those places, and you have to file them nice and round. Let me show you. And like I said, the quality of this is incredible. Like, the metal's harder. It's just way, way better. So you get in there with one of these, right? And you carefully, let me show you here. See, so you do that to all those channels. You make that edge nice and smooth. Like, this bottom edge is sharp like a razor blade. I'm gonna clean one super good and just show you guys what it looks like. Okay, so there we go. See, it's like rounder now. So now the other thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take this type of tip and we're gonna smooth it out just so it's nice and smooth. Okay, let's do that and I'll show you. All right, I mean, it is very hard to see, but this is like round now. It's not super sharp edge anymore. So I did that all around. So now we're gonna take some 320 grit sandpaper and we're just gonna smooth it out, but with our finger, and I'll show you. And that's what you gotta do to all of them. All right, so there it is. Like, that's what that should look like, see? No sharp edges. I mean, it is hard to see on a camera, but I'll show you one that's got a sharp edge for comparison. Right? I mean, look how sharp that edge is compared to that. Right? Maybe from the side. So that's what you got to do. Here, I'll do those two and I'll show you what that looks like. And if you buy a cheap kit that's like half the money of this, you literally got to get all these little carbide tips, and you have to get in there and you have to clean every single piece in there, because all those little particles, the second you start it up, they go right into your motor. So at least with this nice brand name one, so you don't have to do that. That's ready to go in there. Looks the way it's supposed to look. All right, so there you go. See how nice and smooth those edges are now? Nice and smooth. Here, let me show you the other side that hasn't been done yet. See the difference? This is like very, very sharp. It's like it catches your finger like a razor, it feels like. See that? To that. All right, I hope I'm showing that good enough. And also, you have to do the same thing. See underneath here? So you got to do it to this big hole and to these edges here, all of those edges. And I even go as far as on the actual piston, just a little bit there with sandpaper. This is aluminum, so it sands a lot easier. And same with this, just right there, like anything that's sharp and right there. You gotta just smooth it out just a little bit so nothing catches. Don't touch there, that's all good. All right, see this super, super sharp edge here? So you just take your sandpaper. That's it, that's all it needs. Just a tiny little bit. Just to smooth it out. So it's not so catchy. See, just like that. See, that feels a lot better. And same with that, same with these two holes and that side. All right, so off camera, I'm gonna do this whole thing now. I'll quickly show you guys when it's done, and then we're gonna start with the reassembly. Okay guys, so we cleaned this thing up super good. We actually used hot water, dried it with a blow dryer, cleaned all these parts so they're all spotless. No metal shavings, new piece of paper, cleaned up our work area. So as you can see, this looks really, really good now. no sharp edges anywhere. I'm very, very happy with it. Feels nice. So that's how you want this. This is ready to be installed. Okay, now we're gonna put these on. There's no writing on any of them, so they both just go on here. There's little pins. See the little pin there? There's a little pin there. And there's a little pin there. So the way that works is when you put your piston ring on, you see these piston rings can go on anyway. It doesn't matter the direction of them because they're all the same. But if your piston has writing on it in one little spot, I will put a link in at the end of this video that will show you how to put them on if they're a different style. But on this particular scooter, it doesn't matter how you put them on. You just put them on whichever way, as long as that pin's in between the two spots there. Let's get them on. All right, we've got both those on. So see where the pin is when you're putting it inside the cylinder. This has to go right like this, right where that pin is. So that's how you're gonna do both of them. See that one too, when you slide it inside of there. All right, in order to prep this motor here, we need to get a rag with some like brake cleaner on it. We need to clean all this where the gasket's gonna go super, super good. So you clean that all up. If there's an old gasket on there, you gotta get a razor blade and scrape it off. But in our case, there's nothing on it, it's perfect. So I'm gonna clean all that up, clean these up, and let's get going. Okay guys, we're about to put the piston on the bike. That's the first step, is to put it on the bike over there. So the direction of the piston does matter. See, there's an arrow on top and there's nothing there and there's holes here. So the arrow always points to the exhaust side. So if this is your head, right, there's the exhaust pipe. So this would go in like that, with the arrow facing the exhaust. And if you don't have an arrow, these two holes that suck air in, those line up with this hole away from the exhaust, if that makes any sense. See, like that. So that's your direction. See, like that. Okay, so first things first, we put the bearing back in. If you want to check it, so this is new, this came with the kit. So you just put it through. And I mean, there's no play. Feels good. Spins nice. Okay, so the first thing you do is you take some two-stroke oil. You take your bearing and you dip it in the oil. Boom. See how nice and greasy that is? Now you take your bearing and you put it in there like so. See, there it is. Okay guys, so before you put the piston on, you want to get one of these clips in the piston on one side, and then the other one will have to do it in the bike. Okay, so now we take our piston with these holes facing up. Then we take this, which we also put oil on. That goes into the side of the piston like that. And we got to aim it through the bearing. Not easy, but it will happen. There we go. Boom. Just like that. There we go. Make sure she's in there good. And that's in. See, it's gotta be in there just like that. So it's in there good, right in that groove. Okay, I'll show you the next step. The next step is to put oil on these rings. So we're gonna put some oil on the rings, just like that. Good enough. Okay, so first we put this gasket on. Okay, so we got that on. All right, so now for the tricky part. So this needs to go on, but as we're sliding it on, we have to line up these piston rings perfectly so they're pressed in right on these little dwells, I'll call them. See, like that, and then that goes on. We have to do that to both of them. So we'll do this one first. And once that one's on, then we'll align the other one. Also, we're gonna take a little bit of oil on our finger and grease this thing up inside. So it got oil on it for the first initial start. All right. Okay. All right, we got it in. I mean, another way you could have done it is you could have put the piston into the head first, and then right now you could have put that pin in. So that's two ways of doing it. That worked fine. Basically, if those pins aren't in the right place, the piston ring shouldn't fit, but it fits good, see? All right, so now we put this on. Okay, so before we put this thing together, see, we're giving it a try, and I mean, that feels perfect. So those rings are in the right place. Sometimes there's a gasket and sometimes there's a ring like this. This one has the ring, so you make sure you got that right. And that just goes on like this. So just finger tight at first, okay, and then slowly, one bolt at a time, just lightly start going around, just very, very lightly. Okay, so you want to tighten that between 10 and 12 foot-pounds. So what you would do is you just go around like that. You know, you start off at 6 foot-pounds, and then 7, 8, and you just keep making it tighter, all of it at the same time. I mean, in my case, I've done this so many times, I got a good feel for it, so I'm just gonna go as tight as it'll go without breaking it. But yeah, if you don't have a good feel for this, definitely use a torque wrench and do it to what I said there. You can go online and check for yourself. There's so many different opinions on how tight, but between 10 and 12 should be good. Yes, it's nice and even, nice and even. But if you got a good feel for bolts, I mean, you just put these tight. All right, so we're gonna put the spark plug in. That kit requires a different spark plug. It's a little longer. It is a BR8ES, which is a little bit longer. No big deal. So let's put that in now. Okay guys, so I'm gonna put all this back together now, and then we're gonna go outside and we'll talk about how to break this thing in, first start, that kind of stuff. But remember what I said about the airbox. So make sure when you put your airbox on, it is 100%. You don't get any sand or rocks or anything going in there. See, in our case, this plastic kind of hardened from getting old, so we might need a new one of these, or we'll have to re-silicone it again once we get that in there. We're actually gonna have to take this apart, clean the sponge and all that, but that's for a different episode. So just make sure everything's good and airtight so you don't get any sand or nothing in your thing. All right, let me quickly put this back together and let's go outside. All right guys, I mean, as you can see, it runs great. So what you wanna do is you wanna run this thing for the first entire gas tank. You're gonna mix it 25-to-1 ratio to fuel, so heavy on oil. You're gonna drive it around, feather it around, be super, super gentle with it to break it in. And after you burn the whole first tank, after that, you're gonna, for the rest of its life, you're gonna mix it 40-to-1 and for, you know, the first few tanks, you got to be nice to it. You can't just the whole time, because it's got to break in. So you got to be nice to it, at least 3 full tanks. And then after that, it should be all right to start giving her lots of power and actually enjoying the thing. So, oh yeah, and another thing, if you have fuel injection, so that injects 50 to 1, so then you gotta do some math to the gas to get the right ratios. You get what I'm saying? Anyways, I'll leave that up to you. Make sure you subscribe, make sure you subscribe, make sure you subscribe.